This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. In this tutorial, we're going to briefly describe a typical Django request response cycle. The benefit of learning the Django request response cycle, it provides us a visual overview of how data is handled within Django. It will then help us understand a little bit more about middleware, where we're moving towards in this course. Once we have described the Django request response cycle, that will give you a much better understanding of what a Django view and a Django URL is and why it's important for us to actually build, for us to actually fulfill the request response cycle. So this is a very cut down version, but let's imagine we have a client, a browser, a user who's accessing our Django service. So the user would type in something into the URL, into their browser, and then that would send a request over to our Django application. Now, one of the first stages of this request is that it will traverse, it will move through all of the Django middleware that's specified in your application. So go back to your application, if you've got it open, open up the project folder. In this case, it's SQL middleware folder. Go to settings, and you're looking for around about line 43. You'll notice that we have specified here, or there is specified middleware. So this was already pre-created when we created the Django application. So what's happening here, and the order is important, because what's going to happen here is the request is going to come into the application. It's going to hit this middleware first, and then move down to this one, and then move through this one, and so on. So our middleware that we're going to create in this course, we're going to place it maybe at the bottom of this list or at the top. It doesn't matter necessarily. But what's going to happen is that request that is being sent to our server, that's going to hit our middleware. And then our middleware, the code in the middleware, is then going to be initiated. So once we're finished with the middleware, the request now will be processed by the URL functionality. So what Django is trying to do here is to match the URL request, or sorry, just the client request, to a view. So we're trying to build a way of identifying that particular request to a particular functionality that the application provides. So the URL is going to route that request to a particular view, which is then going to perform some sort of action. Now, when you're developing a Django application, it doesn't matter if you create the view first or the URL first, but what does matter is that you have both of them working together and that you are directing requests to views. So we'll see that in this course, how we're going to connect that up. First of all, in this course, we are going to work and build the view and then work backwards and then create the URL. So once Django has determined and matched the client request to a URL, it would then be sent off. I say this lightly, it would be sent off to the view. So then the view will then get initiated. So the view is, think of it as the actual logic, the business logic, the actual thing that's going to perform some sort of action. So in our view, we would have some code which would then perform some sort of action that is expected from the request. Obviously, if we're going to request a web page, then we're going to expect that web page. So the view here is going to be able to communicate with the database, grab some data. It's going to be working with templates so that we can then prepare that data potentially and then send that back to the client. Now, the last step happens to be the first step. We would then move through the middleware once again from bottom to top, and then that would then be sent back to the client. So once the request has moved through the middleware once more, it will then be sent back to the client, and then hopefully that request would then have been resolved. An important seed here to plant is the fact that we're going to be building middleware. In order for us to test that middleware, we are going to need to simulate this idea of a client sending a request to the application. If we, for example, were just to test the view and the URL, we will miss this step of Django passing that request through the middleware. Something to think about and something we'll touch upon and revisit later on in this course. So hopefully it's also clear as to what a view does now. The view is going to have some sort of logic, some sort of action that's going to be performed when a client requests that particular resource. So back into our application here, let's go ahead and create a new view. Now, if we go back into the app that we created, the file here has already been created. All we need to do is create a new view. Now, this is going to be a function-based view. There are different types of views here in Django. It's going to be a function-based view. So this is Python. So we can call this home. It doesn't really matter at this point. I'm just going to call this home, this resource, referring to the home page, for example. And then I'm going to now think about creating some sort of functionality. Now, remember, what we're trying to do here is to create middleware, which will check or provide us information about queries that have been performed within our application. So our application is going to need to perform some sort of query. It's going to need to access the database table that we've just created. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, what we're going to do here is create a simple query. Now, in order to do that, we're going to need some different resources. So we're going to need to bring in the model that we created. So I reference the models file here. And then we want to import the product information or the product table. So this now provides me information about that table. So I can now perform actions on it. So let me just grab that table or reference to that table. In order for me to send or to do anything with my database, I need to use a manager, so a model manager. The manager is essentially a doorway to being able to create a query in Django here and actually then perform that action. If you come from a background where you're familiar with SQL code, you'll know about creating SQL statements to perform actions in the database. So here in Django, we don't utilize SQL directly, we can do, but we have the Django ORM, which is going to manage all of that functionality for us. It's going to create the SQL statements, send it to the database, perform the action, and then just return all the objects from the database. So here we're going to need the manager, which is by default is just called objects. That's going to then help us or provide us some more tools in actual fact in this case. And then we want to return all the data. So we specify the all function here, which is then going to be converted into SQL code, sent to the database. It's going to ask the database for all the data inside the product table, and then it's going to return it. So we're going to need to return it to something. So it returns a query set. So I'm going to just briefly describe this variable here as a QS, query set equals. So we're going to grab all the data from the product table and return it into this variable here. Right, sorry, I didn't mention pass. Why did I add pass if you're not familiar with that? It just means that if I don't use pass, you can see that this is going to break. This code will fail. It will cause an error. By using pass, it's just basically telling Python that just to ignore everything, just carry on as normal. So it's just a placeholder. Right, so we don't need that anymore. So we now have a query. Now, we're not building a website at all here, so we don't need to return a template, a HTML template here. So we can just return a response of some sort. So we're going to return some JSON, I think, in this case. So let's go ahead and bring in some resources. What we're going to do, we're going to grab the data from the table. We're going to then serialize the data, so convert it into JSON, serialize it into JSON format, and then we're going to pass it back to the front end so we can view and see what data has been returned from the table. So now it just becomes an exercise of creating JSON and working with JSON within a view here. So let's go ahead and now import some tools that we're going to need. So JSON, and then let's go ahead and from the django.http, let's import a JSON response. So there's different types of responses that we can create here in Django. Maybe a HTTP response. So a typical traditional HTTP response to return maybe a template or some HTML data. But here we're going to return a JSON response. Right, okay, so we're going to grab all the data from the database. Now, as it stands, that data cannot necessarily be utilized or presented in a way by default, because it is returned as a query set, which is a specialized type of format, let's say, that Django utilizes that we can then use to view the data in Python. So we're going to need to format this. So we're going to, first of all, serialize this. So serialized data equals serialize. So we're just converting our data, if you like. Serialize. Actually, I didn't bring that in. So let's do that. From, wondering why that didn't pop up. Django.core.serializes. Go ahead and import serialize. So we're going to serialize something. So we specify that we want to serialize into JSON. And then what do we want to serialize? Our query set. Okay. And then we need to make sure that's an equals, of course. Right. So that's our data serialized. And then we're going to prepare it. So let's go ahead and say serialized. That's not right, is it? Serialized. Serialized data again. So we take this data now. And we're going to use json.loads and then serialize data. So the loads method is used to pass the valid JSON string that we've created here and convert it into a Python dictionary. Once you've done that, we can then utilize that and then pass it over to the JSON response and actually then return that data back to the client. Now, there are many ways of handling JSON here. This is just one of many. So return, so it's going to be a JSON response. So we're going to return the serialized data and then also a status code, HTTP status code of say 200. So if this is returned, it's going to return a status code of 200, which typically means in the HTTP world that everything is okay. So that's the functionality that's going to be fired or triggered whenever a user or a client, sends a request to a URL, which is pointed to this view. Now, remember, this is only going to be initiated should a request be sent to a URL, which is then connected to this view. So that's the next step for us to now build a URL and connect it to this view so the user can make a request to that URL, and then that URL will then essentially trigger this code. It will then trigger this query. So therefore, when our middleware is installed and created and installed, it will then capture what query was actually generated. That's the idea.